So with the introduction, yeah, he will give introduction.
The yogi who can arouse the kundalini of an individual or give a divine experience, so whosoever desires that. He has been initiated, given the power of awakening of kundalini shakti by Paramahansa Parivajaka Acharya, Sri Loknath Tirtha Swami Maharaj, a Bengali Swami, who has done a lot of penance and got from deity a wonderful power to awaken the kundalini by sankalpa. And the same is true with our Gurudev. Our Gurudev was initiated at the age of 23 when he was learning the second year of his engineering education. He is a Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Engineering, and Master of Engineering from Calcutta University. I feel he has a more connection with Bengal, with the Swamiji as well as education is concerned. And that's a real pleasure that he has come here to give a lecture to your audience. Moreover, after doing the penance for the last 30, 40 years, that whatever grace, whatever trapa prasad he obtained from his Gurudev, he felt that he must distribute or he must pass on this trapa prasad to each and every individual on the earth, whosoever desires that this should be passed on. This yoga should make the one's life fulfilled in a total way, and that is strived since beginning. He felt that I must do this. He felt that not to do or not to distribute this knowledge is a sort of a guilt, a sort of a guilt that way that he will not give it to others. So he must give it to. And with this intention, he started the practice, guidance of Siddha Yoga. With his devotion, he has almost 35 to 40,000 disciples in India. Not only that, his disciples are spread over the 25 nations in the world today. And he is on a tour of USA, London, from 2nd August to 18th October, for this purpose only, that this path should be given to each and every person on the world, in the world. So that this is not particularly restricted to India or some people or some cult or some religion, but it should be given to all and everybody. With this intention, Swami has started. He, as an engineer, I was bring notice that whatever analytical mind is there, that analytical mind he has brought into this spirituality, and he has put up such a wonderful philosophy that as if a 2 plus 2 gives something, definitely, like that he has put up the divine experience in such a way that any common man who is simply following his rules can get the divine experience. He has worked as a superintendent engineer with the government of Maharashtra. Not only that, in divine field, he has done accomplished job in service also. He was given a gold medal for his research work on water analysis by Government of India and Institute of Engineers. Not only that, he has published almost 15 research papers on his work in the engineering field. With this worldly affair, he has proceeded in the field of divine, and that divine field is naturally astonishing that a lot of people are getting experiences of divine nature that way, and everybody's life is becoming more fulfilled. During the early age itself, he was told that he has taught the children who have failed that way, or who are working in the open party, etc. He has worked for them, he has strived for those people and brought their life on a higher plane. He has established about 40 centers in India to get the guidance for the India. He has traveled north to south and west to east in India. Not only that, he has traveled to Bhutan, and now he is a foreign traveler. With these 40 centers, in addition to that, he has established 4 4 pithas in India, one at Banaras, second at Madhya Pradesh in Hoshangabad, third at Rameshwaram, and fourth he intends to establish at Narsingh Sarathiwadi in Kolhapur, Maharashtra. With this tremendous work, he is flowing with energy. With 80 years that he said that he, my only aim is to that I must give information to each and every individual on the earth, whether they follow or not is another aspect, but I must bring to the notice that this yoga is such a wonderful and everybody on the world, earth should get a full enjoyment out of this. That way their life should be fulfilled. I pass out to Maharaj without taking much time. I request him to start. Thank you.
Salutations to my Sadguru, Sri Loparatha Tirtha Swami Maharaj, here all aspirants and studious people who are desirous of knowing about the Siddha Yoga. This has the origin of Vedas, Upanishadas, as well as Srimad Bhagavad Gita. I think many of you must have read Bhagavad Gita. At the end of each canto, adhyay, it is stated Srimad Bhagavad Gita su, Upanishad su, Brahma Vidyayam Yoga Shastri, Sri Krishna Arjuna Samvade, and the name of that particular canto. So this is a study of Brahma Vidya one way. Not only that, but interim Yoga Shastra too. No doubt there are different ways of yoga, that you already must have known that Parapujaniya Sri Ramdevara Yadav also spreading about the Hatha Yoga Vidya, and all are being benefited by the asanas, pranayams, etc. Though the four types are there, Hatha, Mantra, Laya, and Raj. But what is this Siddha Yoga? Actually, it is a crude thing And therefore, when a crude thing is brought before you, naturally, you will be amazed to see that without much efforts, this Siddha Yoga can be imbibed in all the aspirants as well as all the people on this earth space. And for this purpose, my Gurudev has stated that this should be spread to all the people. When I say this, naturally, this should have a common base which could be understood by everybody on earth space. If it is difficult, already elaborated by some Sanskrit verses, etc., there are no doubt. But still, everybody on earth space cannot understand Sanskrit or some terminology of the Yoga Shastra. Yoga has already been defined as Yoga Samadhi, as Vyasa Maharshi says. That way, we have to lead all the people to all this spiritual height. How it can be done? Unless a common platform, common thing which is available with everybody on the space, is not possible. So we say that the common factor in all every living being, I say, it is nothing else but the energy or the prana shakti which is with everybody. He may be an ant, may be an elephant, he may be even learned Guruji. But in everybody, this prana shakti is definitely existing. Now, so when with this common platform, in order to study this Siddha Yoga, where I had asked my Guruji, Lokanathina Swami Maharaj, there are so many works, so much literature is there. So kindly let me know a single works which will be useful for my whole life mission. Then he ordered me that I should do and recite and go deep in Bhagavad Gita. While reading this, in one verse, Lord is explaining this Siddha Yoga pattern. Apiche Sudaracharo Bhajatevam Ananyava. Though I am giving some Sanskrit slokas, I will also let you know what is this common translation. Apiche Sudaracharo, a wicked man, vicious. One day what happened? One man came to me and when he read our literature, he said, I have done all the bad things. You don't ask me what I have not done. Meaning thereby, I am so bad man. Why you are telling me and how I can be lifted? Then I said, all right. Lord has already assured us. Apiche Sudaracharo Bhajate Mam Ananyabhag. With concentrated mind and with the wish that all the things which I have already done, very bad things, I should be adorned with this Siddha Yoga. But one thing is definite, that he has to make up his mind. Bhajate Mam Ananyabhag. All right, though I have done many verses and all those things, still, I will be definitely pure by your Siddha Yoga. Not only that, Bhagavan himself says, Kshipra Bhava Dharmatma, when he has accepted the Diksha, or when he has resolved his mind that I will start and enter in the Siddha Yoga pattern, Bhagavan says, all right, you are this resolved mind will definitely lead you to the ultimate stage. Bhagavad Gita, as you know all, is an essence of the Vedas and the Upanishads too. Of course, Vedas are not to be sung by all, because there is a system, discipline of saying and telling to all the people. Upanishads are there. 120 Upanishads are there with us. And therefore, it will not be possible to know all the things to all the people, and therefore some essence should be taken out and given to the people. Sarva Upanishado Kavo. All cows are there, like Upanishads are compared to the cows. Dogdha Gopal Nandana. Who is to milk all these cows now? Bhagavan Sri Krishna, who is taken as this Krishnam Vande Jagat Guru. So he has given this Gita Amrita, the nectar of Bhagavad Gita, to all the world, so that all the unwanted things in our life are to be washed off. Everybody is therefore eligible one way, because the duty for this Siddha Yoga is the thing is, but the common fan will also understand is Prana Shakti. I think nobody will say that I don't know Prana Shakti, because his life is completely full of Prana Shakti only. If the Prana Shakti is not there, what happens to the body, you know? How to worship, how to inculcate ourselves, imbibe ourselves, and know the reality of the world. But in order to do that, he has assured that Epishya Baba Yonayaha Striyo Vaisya Sadasudra Tepi Yanti Paramgatim. By this Siddha Yoga study, when he has accepted, slowly, Sudras, Epishya Baba Yonayaha, very serious professors, also Vaishyas, and all the people in the world can have this and have a possibility of acquiring this Siddha Yoga. Now we have to know today, say some specialities of this Siddha Yoga. First I may say, because due to this practice, all the first enumerated Siddha Yoga is a complete composition of Hatha Yoga, Mantra Yoga, Laya Yoga and Raja Yoga too. By giving advice to Arjuna, who was tempted and he just thrown out his instrument for battle, that may be there, but in order to remove that temptation, that these are my brothers, how I can kill them? Oh Lord, why you are telling me like that? Shala, Sammanjita, they are my schoolmates, they are my samgurus are there, and you are telling me to kill them? Lord slightly stared and got slightly angry and told him, Klaibhyamma sarvava partho naipatvavi papandhati. Meaning thereby, don't be coward like that. On the battlefield you are asking me this. Is it correct? We have tried all ways, different ways, to pacify and remove their ignorance. So, you should, and may be there, but in order to remove that temptation, that these are my brothers, how I can kill them? Oh Lord, why you are telling me like that? Shala, Sammanjita, they are my schoolmates, they are my samgurus are there, And you are telling me to kill them? Lord slightly stared and got slightly angry and told him, Klaipyamma Sarvava Partho Naipat Bhavi Papandhati. Meaning thereby, don't be coward like that. On the battlefield you are asking me this. Is it correct? We have tried all ways, different ways, to pacify and remove their ignorance. So, you should now hear me what I am saying. And the whole Gita is like that, a counsel, advice, to remove all kinds of temptations in the life. Like that, when he was advising Arjuna, he told, for perfection of our life, you must become a yogi. All other measures are there. Penances are there. Different literatures are there. Different good deeds are there. Why Lord has specifically stated you become a yogi? Tapasya Vedika Yogi. Penances are there. Yogi is superior to that. Jnani Bhyo Matodhika. Different literatures and different knowledges are there. Till you become a yogi. Karmi Bhyas Chadhika Yogi. Different hospitals are consulted. Dams are consulted. That's also a very good thing. Till you become a yogi. In order to have the perfection of the life and Krita Krityasya Bharato, it is necessary that you should become a yogi. In Bhagavad Gita, there is on the 9th canto, Adhyaya, Lord, Sri Krishna is explaining them about this Raja Vidya. Raja Vidya is a compound, not the Vidya of all the kingdoms and kings which are now ruling all over the world. No. Raja Vidya is Vidyanam Raja. Adhyatma Vidya, Vidyanam. So we have to go in for this Shrestha, very superior Yoga Vidya, Brahma Vidya, and in time also the Yoga Vidya. This Siddha Yoga has been already described in all the scripts, and they have told that it is very necessary that a man should leave his body by doing yoga only. Yogenante tadutyajam. Body to be left, everybody has to leave the body. But he has to leave the body by practicing yoga only. Raja Vidya, Raja Vayam. The highest learning, Raja Vidya. Vidyanam Raja. Similarly, this is that way he has spoken the secret of the whole universal kingdom and whatever the things are going on. Secret is there, Raja Guhyam. Guhyanam Abhi Raja. Topmost secret. So today, that way, our topic is very important because it is an explanation towards Brahma Vidya, Yoga Vidya, Raja Vidya, and therefore it should be spoken to all the people who are interested, who have some aspiration regarding yoga. Further he says, it's all right, it may be very good, but people will ask whether it can be explained by everybody on the earth's face. So, we definitely say that, yes, it can be done, definitely. Pratyaksha avagamam, avagama is to know a particular thing. Pratyaksha avagamam, dharmam, susukam kardovye, it may be very good, available for everybody. When it's easy to perform also, yes. Susukham kartum. For doing that also, it is very easy. I may slightly overwhelm and say, yes, nothing is so simple as Siddha Yoga. Susukham kartum amya. So today, we are having some salient points about this Siddha Yoga. Common for what is the common deity? I have told. Prana Shakti is the deity, which everybody will definitely have. Nobody can deny. He may deny. Sometimes we always say that mother energy or the life force or whatever you call it is the mother for all. Nobody can say that I don't want this mother. Because without mother energy, your life structure will never be standing on good days. So in order to know properly this prana shakti or the breathing, which is a permanent thing, prana, life force, is a permanent thing which everybody has been donated when you took the birth. Nobody will say that this is not my mother, mother energy is not my mother. But while speaking also, you will have to think twice, because without mother energy he cannot speak also. Let us go ahead. We have our life structure. First of all, body is there. What is in the body? One thing is, you will know what is in the body. Whether the body itself is doing something or there is some other force which is moving the body and having the all performance of our life structure. Body is there, but mother energy is there, and therefore the body is important. If the mother energy is not there, it will all know what happened. What happened once a quarrel started within the organs in the body. Ears explain their importance. You want to hear music? You want me or not? So I am important. My party is strong. Tongue also started what you are saying. You want to have some delicious food or not? Tasty bodies if you want. It is necessary that my presence is definitely important. Like the nose also stand up, some fragrances, some scents are there. So my presence is a must. Like that, the eyes also stared and stared. Well, you want to see the world or not? So eyes are also prominently saying that I am important. When this quarrel was going on, the mother energy, on the strength of which all were working, she told all these organs, what are you, why are you so much quarreling? When I am fed up with all your quarreling, I will go out for 1 hour. What happened? When she started going out, ears are there. Good music is being sung. But I am not able to hear. Similar tongue is there, very delicious and very good material kept before you. Watering perhaps the tip must have started also. But what happened? There is no taste to my tongue. Because the mother energy, which energy the taste was being experienced. Similarly, the eyes also told. So look at that, you must understand what I want to say. Because due to energy only, mother energy is there, pranashakti is there, every limb has got its importance. If the mother energy is not there, no happiness, no joy can be experienced. So prana is supposed to be the real friend of a man. We say, he is my intimate friend. All right, it may be, but some differences started, they said, we will not come together. But can it be saved by the prana shakti? No. Because it is the only good friend which is a permanent, which will not leave the body. It will leave the body. But if it has left it, then you have no existence at all. Prana sakha. You understand? What I wanted to say is, importance of prana is very important. Maybe, but there is some superiority of the to the body, to the superiority body. Yes. Anything we do, first of all, the mind has got a particular thought and the action is being taken up. Meaning thereby, mind is superior to body. If you have some troubles, aching in the head, aching in the top, some troubles are there. But if the mind settles, no, whatever may be position of my body, still I will go there. Mind is the servant of the body. One way. So mind is also important. All right. Let us go ahead. What about the mind now? What is mind? Mind is just a thought. When any thought comes, it's a mind. General definition. So it is important. No doubt. Because unless the mind thinks, nothing can be done. But what is the nature of the mind? At one time, it will say, you give me the presidency of America, I will rule over the things. Whatever bad things, I will just rule it out. Very high thought. At the same time, after some time or some term incidences, your mind will be so low, you yourself will ask, why? I am such a now big man, I have no age over there. Still, I have got these bad thoughts. So can this mind be taken as an idol which can be followed and which should be dependent upon? We say that mind is all, but there is, I will just let you know, regarding mind, there is a comparison made in our Purusha Sutra. What they say? Chandrama, Manaso, Jata, Shaksho, Suryo, Ajayata. On one side, mind is there. It is just like moon is there. Mind, very high thoughts, low thoughts. Similarly, the Chandra or the moon, it will have full moon day. And for 14 days, 15 days, it will be no moon day. On the other side, the sun is there, due to which the Chandra is there. Moon is there. All right. Similarly, we have got prana shakti. Because the prana shakti is there, mind is there. Please hear carefully, because this is the basis of our further practical. I am going to tell you some practical also. Holy speech will not carry you whatever I want to say to you. So when prana shakti is there, the mind is there. What is important? Whether the mind is important or the prana shakti is important, the natural answer is wind or the air which is passing through the lungs is more important than the mind itself. Because mind is only there, mind is so wavering. So we will not give more importance to mind also. For both body and mind, what is important? The prana shakti, the mother energy is there, then the body is important. If the mother energy is not there, what happened to the body, you know? Similarly, when the mother energy is there, mind is there. Mana bhavanachi, khelani, atma sukhachi, balaleni, levavisi. Yamishara is very nice. Mind and wind, what is important? So we can come to the conclusion that wind is more important. Prana shakti, mother energy is more important for all the things. In order to have experience of the only mother energy, not the body, because mother energy is important, the body, mother energy is important, is important, mind also. So let us try to separate and divide of body and mind. This is Siddha Yoga, where mother energy is being tackled and pondered upon. How to do it? For that we will have some slight practical. What practical is to be done? First of all, now let us go in for the procedure. How Siddha Yoga introduction can be known to you. So what we do? Close eyes. Why? Because when you are open to all the things, we are seen by all the things. So your mind cannot be concentrated. So in order to start our meditation practice, introduction, what is to be done? Close the eyes. Perhaps you must have not exactly knowing what happens when the eyes are closed. When the eyes are closed, you will definitely find, slightly minutely seeing, you will find that a backbone current just comes up. Automatically, in everybody, close eyes, you definitely feel that something is coming from the backbone and residing in the brain itself. Please open, because I want to do some further things. Otherwise, you will go in meditation and my speech will be of little value. The first very important thing, by which in Yoga Shastra they say as Pratiprasava Marga. When we are saying, we have all our senses going, all those things. But if the power and mother energy is coming up and up, you will have a kind of eternal bliss slightly touching you. So close the eyes, let the prana shakti coming up and up, rushing up and up from the backbone. Another thing is, you have to relax the body. Relaxation is up to what? Maximum relaxation, which will allow the internal air or the mother energy to travel somewhere. Correct? So relaxation is a very important thing in this Siddha Yoga. Let us now close the eyes. Mind will be there, but mind has been told that you are there only because the wind is there. So we'll leave off the mind also and we'll see that only and only, only air is to be meditated, which is with everybody. So I will always say that this path is to be led to every lane, every street or everybody's house by a very simple method. In order to do that, the first step I have told, close the eyes, let the mother power coming up and up, rushing up and up. Body is not there. What is air then? Air is to be meditated. Only air. Chidananda rupa shivoham shivoham. How to do it? Practically we have to see that. In order to have this, as you will have about 11 minutes practical to know the mother energy, the prana shakti, which is ruling the body as well as the mind. Process I have already told. Close the eyes. Backbone, air is coming up and up. Relaxation is there, the body is not to be considered at all. One thing you might also know it, notice it. When, with devotion, with love, affection, the cries are closed. Sraddhaya parayopeta. With motivation. You are the only mother of the whole world. Air is a mother for all the world. Nobody can deny, as I have already explained. He may deny, but it is not correct. Because without his existence is only due to the mother energy. So now, eyes closed, mind more entirely in the automatic. Automatic is a very important word. If you force me, keep the breath, then mind will be entering. But if automatic, this breathing is taking place, let it be done. I think you got the point, what a procedure will be there. Very easy, very easy. So let us have this practical for 11 minutes and then I will again explain all. All to whom? Your gods and goddesses. What is God? God is not a body. God is not a mind also. The prana shakti is the God for all, everybody on the earth's face. So we have to worship. To whom? Not worship to the God. Not any incarnation. No doubt. Other worships are there. You can do, definitely you are good. We also bow to our mother, etc. That is correct. But what are gods and goddesses? What is God? God is not a body. God is not a mind also. The prana shakti is the God for all, everybody on the earth's face. So we have to worship. To whom? Not worship to the God, not any incarnation. No doubt, other worships are there. You can do, definitely you are good. We also bow to our mother, etc. That is correct. But what is important is to worship your own Nasa Bhantara Charino. They are floating through your nostrils. That is meditated upon, and it is not to be restricted in any way. Pranayama is not to be done. Who will do the pranayama? The pranayama will be done by the mother energy whenever she is omnipotent and omniscient. So we say that by closing the eyes, let the air have the full free flow without any restriction of the mind and the body also. No posture is necessary. Some people ask me, why you are not asking the posture, particular pose or position? Patanjali Mahamuni has already defined asana, sthira sukham asanam. Only two things. Position of the body is another part, but sthirata, steadiness of the mind and the body to both. Sukha, it should be pleasant. Some aching is there in the body, it is not asana. A good asana, the best asana is sthirata, steadiness and also shanti, pleasantness. As if I am not a body, I am not a mind, I am only the air passing through the nostrils. So let us now study this for 11 minutes. I think you will not agree because this is very easy. Otherwise, I will say that you are not doing anything. You will be very pleased, Babu. Very good. We are not doing anything because when we want to do something, we are also troubled that way. So let us have this practical for 11 minutes. And after that, I will let you know what is Siddha Yoga, the grandeur, the solidity of bliss, which has given to everybody on earth first, that should be shown and be thought now. So for 11 minutes, I have got the watch. After 11 minutes, say about 11 minutes, we will have the meditation of what? Not the body, relaxation, mind. Told that because the mother energy is there, you are there. So we will only adorn and worship only the mother energy. That is the air flowing through, automatic air flowing. Therefore, not to be stalked, taken briskly, or kept outside for a minute of pranayam, kumbhak, rechap. You are not doing. That is the speciality of Siddha Yoga, that you are not doing anything. Everything will be done by the mother energy as per her wish, H capital. You are not, because you are there only, because the air is passing through, there is air. And that I must tell you, that this is the only permanent thing which has been given by the God to us. Everybody, every creature also. We are thinking only upon the human being. Let us at least, let them know at least, come together with this habitable bliss. So now we will have for 11 minutes and then I will ask you to further specialities of Siddha Yoga. Bhagavan, Lord Krishna Paramatma, let it add on Krishna Paramatma, or that is nobody, nothing else, mind is also not there. You have to start this from this now time. This is a very highest worship everybody can do in his life. Without any strains of the body, because relaxation has started. When the relaxation has started, you will feel very light and light and light. You may be very fat or like that, but when you start worship with complete relaxation, a bliss will definitely enter in you and have the experience of solitary bliss. In short, the body is not there, only the air is the essence of all the world. Relax, relax, relax. Up to what? If the body is not there, only the air is there. Tada Adhurtu Surup Ayavasana Surup is Prana Shakti is your real essence. Worship thyself. Whatever is observing, let it be observing what is happening, how the air, mother air is being adorned. Let her passage be, entire free passage is very necessary. No restriction of the prana shakti's flow. Relax, relax, relax. Backbone current is coming up and up and up. that air going through the nostrils, let it flow full freedom to the air flow. Only examination of the mind, only air to be thought of, passing through automatic air flow. To be merged entirely with the automatic airflow. Mayyave shamano yema. Man that I have done, kindly open the eyes. Very, 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 very slowly open the eyes. So this is an introduction. How to enter Siddha Yoga, in which you are not doing anything but allow the air. Air, mother, is the essence of our whole structure. So this is one of the simple techniques which will definitely give you the internal, real, godly bliss. You can try anytime. When you are awakening at night, somewhere midnight like that, you can say that this is, I am only here. And when you say like that also, lightness comes to you. That is the effect of Siddha Yoga practices also. Apukrishattvam vadane prasannata, all these effects are nearby. Siddha Yoga is an essence of all kinds of Veda. I may say anything, but Lord Krishna has stated this path by saying, we now decide that we have to go to this Brahma Pada. A gold and amrita coin, nectarious coin, can be given to everybody all over space. How to do it? This is just a trial I have given you. This may be done at any time except full Bedi Sulbhadra. Belly should be slightly empty, not fully empty. So you can try this at any time. This is an introduction towards the Siddha Yoga, which I think you must have felt that you have to do anything. Whatever the passage of the air, the mother is the energy for all the people. I have already told that nobody can deny this mother's bliss. We may say that the whole world is full of air, pure air. If one mother is only one, because air is everywhere one. In Italy, Russia, anywhere, air is only one. So mother is only one. When mother is only one, naturally all of us will become the brothers. Naturally, you may differ, but you please What I am saying, please thoughtfully you see whatever. If mother is one, there is mother for all the people. Naturally we have got this brotherhood is automatically established. There is no need to prove it. Vishwa Bandhutva. What is Bandhan? Prana is the Bandhan for all. I think you must have caught what I want to say. So this kind of Siddha Yoga practice introduction let it be known to all the people. Like that we had taken the trials also. Just I had asked you to sit and they said, when we had a good trial, we have the global trial. On 25th January 2007, we had asked the people, everybody on our space should link this, sit like that. What is the criteria? Close the eyes, let the backbone, when it comes up and up, relax the body and only think about the flow. Prana saustham manakrutva adhikinchi labhishintai. Bhagavan has told it. Don't have any other things in the mind. Mind to be told that you are much because you are air is there, your existence is there. So you go to the existing most important thing in your life. Like that we have taken this trial and many people have communicated to us that it was a very good and enjoyable without body and mind. Not completely, but a part. Pratyaksha avagamam, pratyaksha, you will see that you must feel how something is going there. I am not attending to the body perfectly. I am not attending to the mind also. But I am attending toward the air flow, which is a permanent thing. Body is not permanent, mind is also not permanent. What is the reality? This is the reality what we see. Like that, we had taken such trial. Now another trial on 10th of February. Time will be given. For 21 minutes, everybody on the earth should sit there. I have taken the practical. How to sit? What is the procedure? I may again repeat slowly. Close the eyes. Let the mother energy and the prana vayu come up and up. Relax the body. Body is not important. Mind to be thrown and completely made one with the air and only air is to be thought of. Another thing to do. Like that, we are having such trials which will slowly lead to the samadhi. Slowly. Shanai, shanai, raparame. Adhyay, 6th canto, 6th, 25th verse. Shanai, shanai. We have to take all the people of the whole world, we have to take to the particular piece. Shantyam Nirvana Parama Mas Samstham Adhikachyati. This peace is the institute of the God. For that only, Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. All right. We already have this peace. This is a very simple procedure to lead to the Shakti Jagrana. Shakti Jagrana is we have got the power. But there are certain, due to the tendencies, different wishes, desires, it is covered. In order to know the reality, what we have done? Body is not there, relaxation of the body. Mind to be merged in the automatic air flow. It has been covered, topic is there. No, the topic is there. But slowly, when the mind also merges in the air flow only, you will be only one air only. Slowly, Sviyam Samyam Vidhate, this kind of diksha will lead you to the maximum solitary bliss. Because our wishes are there, no doubt. Wish is a deposit on the Chaitanya. Wish is a deposit on the Chaitanya, that is the airflow or the mother energy. When any thought comes, we are polluted over it. Not only that, if only single word is spoken, mind, God, dhoti, whenever you speak the word, the peace is disturbed. Any word spoken will disturb. Some of the words are not there. Please hear what I am saying now. No words are there. When you decide like that, when you think like that, then word is not there. No words are there. Immediately the peace must start. This is the method, and therefore we say, Jinyasurabhi Yogasya Shabda Brahmati Vartaya. All sciences, all these are coined with the words. If the word is not there, I think what I wanted to say, you must have caught up properly. If no word is there, the peace immediately starts. And by cultivation of the mind like this, whatever I have just told, you will have the complete happiness, and no dualities will also trouble. It's a practice. I don't say it will be acquired immediately, one month or it is a continuous process. Vairagya means vigataha ragaha. Ragaha means ranjana. The fondness, no fondness is there, immediately you start. You will come to the peace point. Because the words are there. Words will disturb your peace because chitta. Chitta will be there only if tendency is there. If the tendency is not there, you are free. Not tendency. You will not die, don't worry. If the thoughts are not there, we feel that the thoughts are not there. What will be our existence? Yes. You will be perhaps more solidarily come with the reality of the world. If the words are not there also, you will have the complete happiness. As in, because what happens? Our mind is such that you will have always the tendency to catch something. I want something, I want. If the want is not there, suppose you only just say, I don't want anything. Just say it, don't worry. Nothing will wrong is going to happen. When you say like that, immediately the peace will start. Because, why it is so? Because mind is a structure of which the mother energy or the air is there, or the air, any wish sits, touches, and the body is prepared. Without wish, no body can be prepared. Again repeating, due to the wish only, we are here. If the wish was not there of your father or father's father, if the wish was not there, you could not have come here. You get the point? So I may say that your father's father's father, you don't know. Similarly, your son, you will not take your name also. The wish is the Bijammam Sarabhutanam Vidhipara Sanatanam. So while thinking like that, you will definitely go very near to the Atma Shakti, Atma Darshan. I don't say it will be done with the one hour moment, but if this practice is done in the cultivation of the mind is there, therefore Bhagavad has said, we want to give all the people to this nectarial path. Prana Savisham Manakrutva Nakinchada. Bhagavan has told, otherwise he would have told, look to my face, look to my feet, he would have said, no, it is not, he is not like this. He is sitting. Prana Sastam Manakrutva, Prana is the God for all the people, which cannot be done by anybody. మన కృదా నకించదమే చింతయ ఫర్దర్ ఆల్సో హియర్ స్టేటెడ్ యతో యతో నిశ్చరతి మనః చంచలం అస్థిరం మైండ్ ఇస్ వెరీ సెంటెడ్ ఇట్ విల్ ఇమీడియట్లీ క్రాష్ సంథింగ్ బట్ వాట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు డూ అండ్ కల్టివేట్ ద మైండ్ లైక్ దాట్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ కమ్స్ యూ సెడ్ యూ ఓన్లీ ఎయిర్ బికాజ్ ఎయిర్ ఇస్ యువర్ రూట్ ఇఫ్ ద ఎయిర్ ఇస్ నాట్ దేర్ విష్ కెనాట్ సిట్ అప్ ఆన్ దాట్ నో విష్ క్యాన్ బి ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ అన్లెస్ the mother energy or the prana shakti or the air is there. We have already stated that in the mind and the wind, wind is more important and is a totally secret guhyadamam, that is guhyadamam. Now we will speak for 5 minutes, we will have something regarding the diksha. Diksha, there are 2 letters are there, diksha. Diyate ek saranartham. In order to wipe out all the body and the mind elements, this is the practice. How to do? I have told you. It's a practice, no doubt. So, diyate ek saranartham. In order to wipe out all the things, diksha is given. Initiation. Who is giving? Mother energy will be entering your body. That is a secret. When diksha is there, guru diksha, kshatatamaha, all the things which are unwanted, those will be wiped out by the diksha. For that you have to just see what is this path. And when I have told like that, that diksha can be had with anybody on the space. One stalwart from the New Jersey, he has written to me, I want initiation. I said, all right. No restriction. Everybody who will be able to follow the rules, like rules are there, because we have to have one path. Other lanes are definitely to be avoided. Unless you, otherwise you will take more time to reach the destination. Like that, when he wrote to me, I had asked him to sit on that particular day. Then, has written, the next day he has given his beautiful experience he has given. I will just read out what he felt and who he was enchanted 1 minute, charmed. Okay. He's writing me, deep appreciation, thankfulness and satisfaction to Narayan Kaka Dhekane. I just loved it because the diksha is not my, I was just directed you to go on this path. What experiences you are getting? That is the mother energy's power. Anyway, for his kindness in blessing me with Shaktipat Diksha, this January 29, 2001, 6 a.m. I'm going to sit at for your watch, local time. East USA. Send in room at home. He has given the address. You can have the inquiry, whether it is all correct or not. 76 Aronia. R.D. Mendham, N.J. means New Jersey, as instructed from India. I was there in Nasik, he was there in New Jersey at this place. Lo and behold, he said, oh, what is happening in my body? When this diksha is an amazing, wonderful thing in the world itself. And thousands of people, I have got so many experiences from them. The Kundalini Shakti definitely acted, he has confessed. Nobody will confess, only something is moving in the body. The Shakti awakening has started and again he is sitting, sat until 7:30 a.m. He started at 6 o'clock. When he opened the eyes, it was 7:30 in his watch. He has very nicely described the potency of this. The actual beauty, clarity and simplicity of this sadhana or path lies in what? Lies in its call to allow the divine Shakti to do the work of purification. Allow the divine Shakti, mother air. Oh mother, kindly purify me. She will start her work, don't meddle in that. Allow her to do the work of me, that is what we say. allow the divine to do the purification. He is a very what a nice and wonderful way. He is just explaining me again. Simply see, relax for meditation, relax for implementation. That we have done just now. You get the point? Relax for meditation and Shakti takes over. Shakti takes over the Jagrana. And if a baby is being washed by her mother, by his mother, some action do take, but mother will not stop. When she has started the purification method as per his will, her will, the purification will start and she will see that you are completely purified. She will not stop unless the child is completely watered and very clear and have a smiling face. Therefore, Shakti takes over is the very essential secret, Guhyatamam, because one does not know what will happen when the Shakti is arising. But definitely, mother is there, don't worry. Mother will not hurt the child in any way, will not damage in any way. Bad movements of the body due to this child is being washed up. Seriously, Rangam Ankavitam Deenam Tarayantam Padenacha. The wife will have legs thrown off on her mother, but she will not stop. Like that. It is very necessary to allow the divine Shakti to do the purification. Purification will be done by the mother for which you are not doing anything. That is what I told. This is the secret of Siddha Yoga. Don't do anything. You don't do anything, that will be better because she will have the complete facility for washing you properly. Diksha, diksha, sarnartham. Guru Diksha, akshata tamaha. And when such kind of initiation is there, one starlight has already started. When this awakening process starts, it will not stop till the purification is completed. Ek dafe jagrut hui kundarini shakti parasema me pravesh ki bina nahir. She will not stop. It will be possible that you must have some wishes. In another world, also she will catch you by some other method. For that only Purva Abhyasa in a tene, Purva means introductory, because why you have come here? I don't know, you see at some stage you must have been in the last birth, and therefore you have come here to go the further path, what is to be done. You get the point? So, this is greatly helpful and possible, Shakti Awakening by the Computer Master. Once again, thank you dear Guru and Sacred Lineage. That is what I am saying, please help me in the manner that I want to pass up this particular process to all the people in the world. Like that, I may say, I think within 10 days or like that, Mount Valens, some statue of Gandhi Maharaj was there, and there was some program on 11th September program was there. On that day, I also, only 5 minutes given to me. I even had some exclusive, given you all the things. But on that day, they have thanked me because I had in 5 minutes, I have asked them to trip for 2 minutes only. But process, close the eye, let the power come in. Only air is your extension, that is the only reality. When 2 minutes earlier, he has written to me, thank you because Vicky, 1 hour, think they have communicated me that I should attend that. Thank you dear Narayan Dhekane for your beautiful contribution to the topics of the peace and non-violence of this forum. The other 9/11 event on Tuesday, September 2007, at the Gandhi statue in Riverside, she just your presence first of all made an impact. And then your obvious experience dealing with the microphones and made your suggestion, message, so very able to be heard. All people very glad to hear that. You had such a gentle insistence in your, please help me, that I have already said. Please help me. For what? I have taken a somewhat oath as such. I want to have the complete bliss to everybody on our space. Sarve dikshita varikshitaha bhavantu. This is my slogan. Not it will take time, but if you help all, then it is just possible. Anyway, he said, this, to get over, yes, you had such a gentle insistence in your plea, please help me with this, to get the people to close their eyes, relax their body, and feel mother air going in and out of the body. This quiet experience of peace and brotherhood was enhanced by the presence of the gentle breeze coming through the mall at times. Breeze over there. Your presentation was unique in that people got to experience peace within themselves, everybody. While the rest of all the program, our program were there. So many people have tried about the peace. They were mainly hearing about it through the words and songs, but I had not known no words, no singing. Real peace. Words will disturb your peace, that is what I feel. The Inland Communities chapter of the Progressive Council appreciates your participation in this event and wishes you well doing your visit to United States. May you have many opportunities to spread your important message of peace and Siddha Yoga. So they have all met. I am very well glad. Thankful to you, of course. But you also, I would request all the people to have this kind of, to tell everybody with this universal brotherhood is automatically established. Because you are the mother's sons, all we are there. I think whatever I wanted to speak, slightly more time has been taken. But whatever I wanted to pass on, this solidarity bliss as given my Guru Lokanath Swami Maharaj, as well as poor other people, so Vasudeva Saraswati Swami Maharaj, Anandaranandji Gaudiya Maharaj, and also Jayanta Maharaj, who has adorned me and asked me to pass on to, and therefore I am at your service. So all gods and goddesses, why? Because God is everything. Pran is the God. Nobody can deny that God is not with me. You may say, but I will never agree with you. Every entity, inhabitant of the earth, on the earth space, is definitely will have this grandeur of Siddha Yoga. I think my time is more than over. But I am very glad that all you have heard me patiently. And again I wish that this should be accepted and made known to the boy. Practicing any race, even boys should be there. Or even great man be there. But this will be most important. Thank you all, to all.